You know, I like my productions to be like a house that we're building, but I don't finish the house when we get there. I like to leave all the inside open, so I build the structure and the foundation and the roof. And then I leave the inside walls open, so when we get there, we start to build the walls as we see what's working, see how the sun's coming through the window. Part of my style is experimenting and letting things fail. I guess I'm known for, music videos, I guess, mostly, or film. What I know myself for doing is just pushing every time a little bit further. The idea of being able to have full trust to shoot this is what really seemed exciting to me. When you take an artist and let them just be themselves the most and do exactly what they would if they were let to, you tend to get the most beautiful, creative, interesting, far-reaching stuff. There's something about this car to me that looks sort of futuristic and like forward and a little bit mean, maybe. So I thought isolating it out in the desert, taking it away from sort of its natural home, so to speak, and getting it out off the street and into some dusty desert planet. Well, I brought Woodrow Wilson here as our foreground, and the coyote in the desert. He's the guy. He's a good luck charm. The eye line's kind of messed up. We'll fix that. But ideally, it's this gorgeous frame right here.
I don't really shoot cars, so I'm just finding a place right now. But in my mind, the most dynamic car angles tend to be this sort of thing, where it's a three-quarter with the tire crank.
All right, let's flip it around. Just the curves in this thing, especially on the rear end area, are really beautiful to me. So I'm just trying to find a way to shoot it. I'm more shooting it like it's a landscape. I'm gonna go this way though. The front too, I'm gonna try and get. And again, just shoot it differently. The curves to me are so pretty on this thing. Taking it out of the city forces you to look at the lines a little differently too, I think, and sort of observe it more of as a structure or like a sculptural work. It's almost like taking something to an art museum. You know, when you're inside the art museum, you can look at a can of soup differently because your mind's in that place. So I think doing something similar, we're putting a more interesting frame around a car than a city or its natural habitat.
We're just getting the last of this light. I mean, this is like California slather. In the industry, we call it California slather.
Ooh, look at this pretty girl.
Yeah, I guess we're done. This light's done.
Most photos you take is like 1/100th of a second or 500th of a second. So we're going to do 30-second long exposures.
I'm going to just light the car with this thing.
Light painting is all about just experimenting. It's you get what you get when you get it, basically. So it's going to be trial and error.
3, 2.
We can be in the shot, but because we're wearing black and we can move around and the light won't actually catch us.
Ooh. I mean, any light that passes through or around the frame is just gonna look interesting.
So we're just trying using some little colored balls. They're being thrown into the air and it's coming down like rain.
One of my favorite ones, I guess, from earlier was more sort of traditional automotive photography stuff. We went inside the cabin and faced outwards. That was sort of a beautiful little happenstance of mistakery. So there were a couple where I actually took all these and just like literally just threw them up into the air while the camera was open. It was really beautiful. I want to experiment and experiment and experiment. It starts to look okay, and then you just take a breath and then refine it and take it out of experiment and into some sort of professionalism. We found that today relatively quickly. Sometimes it takes a lot longer than that. Throwing LEDs around doesn't always.
We're just going to use one of the intelligent modes on the drone and put it into a circular pattern, and it'll just keep flying around, and we're going to try it above the car and above the mountains over there.
It was sort of a hit and miss until we nailed it, and it's also a matter of getting him to fly in a perfect circle. He's so killer, but it was an awesome collaboration.